ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحابه أجمعين. We all aspire for paradise. It is a goal that we all seek. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in plenty of verses in the Quran gives us a very vivid image of what paradise has to offer each and every one of us. And therefore, when we come to prayer and when we pray outside the masjid environment, whatever good deed we do, in the back of our minds, we want paradise. Because who wouldn't want an eternity in bliss, near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being with family and friends without the fear or the worry that engulfs our daily lives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about paradise in Surah Al-Hajj and what it has to offer. And immediately after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us how to attain it. And this verse is quite a beautiful verse, very well, very eloquent, so beautiful just to recite. And this verse is something that we don't need to get, we have to do more than just live by. We have to feel it. وَهُدُوا إِلَى الطَّيِّبِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ وَهُدُوا إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْحَمِيدِ. Be guided, meaning do what it takes to be on the path of the pure word. The very beautiful word, which is the word of Tawheed, La ilaha illallah. And be guided, do what you need to do, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to do, to be on the path of the most praiseworthy, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes through the next two pages talking about Hajj and the rituals of Hajj. And Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, who is a symbol of Tawheed, a symbol of submission, a close friend to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the two individuals in human history who have attained the level of khulla, a close relationship, a very close relationship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this word khulla, what it means is, you know, in the Arabic language we say mkhallal, to refer to pickles. Something that is pickled. You take it and you put it in vinegar, and the vinegar has such a profound effect on the cucumber that it completely changes it. It reaches every inch, every centimeter of that cucumber until it makes it something completely different. So someone who is a khalil of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is someone whose the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has entered their heart and has entered their body to the extent where it reached every single part of their body. It affects every single action that they do. It affects their perception of life. To tell us, if you want to be on this path of the pure word, the path of the most praiseworthy, that Ibrahim alayhi salam is a great example of that. And in these verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala points to the heart three times. ذَلِكَ وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ حُرُمَاتِ اللَّهِ فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ ذلك ومن يعظم شعائر الله فإنها من تقوى القلوب لن ينال الله لحومها ولا دماؤها ولكن يناله التقوى منكم. In these three verses, just to be concise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that what reaches Him, what counts of your deeds, is that which is coming out of the heart. That which the heart glorifies. When they look at this, saying that this is a ritual that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for us. This is something that gets us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The heart elevates its status to where it appreciates, it feels the sacredness of that which is being done, of the ritual. And sandwiched between these verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a very beautiful analogy. He says, حُنَفَاءَ لِلَّهِ غَيْرَ مُشْرِكِينَ بِهِ. Who are these people who are on the path of the pure word? The path of the most praiseworthy subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are the hunafa. They are the people of monotheism, of tawheed. They are the people whose hearts lean towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, away from everything that takes him or her away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you look at the eloquence of this verse, how it's worded, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts it off by saying hunafa, with this kind of feel that it's raising us, to let us know the one who follows Tawheed is someone who's elevated, someone who's noble, Someone who has been elevated above the worthless things of this life. People who are elevated above that which oppresses them or that which causes them to submit to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that enslaves them from other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hunafa, these are people who are elevated, غَيْرَ مُشْرِكِينَ بِهِ, they don't worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But how about those who worship other than Allah? What is their situation? وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَكَأَنَّمَا خَرَّ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَتَخْطَفُهُ الطَّيْرُ أَوْ تَهْوِي بِهِ الرِّيحُ فِي مَكَانٍ سَحِيقٍ. The one who commits shirk is like the one who is free-falling. They have no control of their actions, and they keep going faster and faster and free-fall. And not only that, there are birds coming and clawing the individual as they are going down. And the scholars say this is the analogy of a heart, of the heart that has been tainted with shirk. Their desires are clawing away at them, hurting them. But they feel at the same time that they have no control of what they are doing of their lives. They feel helpless, they feel hopeless, because they don't have a foundation. Compare that to the person of Tawheed, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates. Who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is holding them, supporting them, protecting them. The one who has designated angels to be a source of protection for that individual. Has designated angels to do istighfar, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them. Angels who make dua for them, that they be people of paradise, them and their families, those who are righteous of them. Compare the two, and all of this is coming out of the heart. If we want to be Muslims, living Islam is a level of iman. But experiencing faith, that's a higher level. These verses are telling us, if you want to experience Islam and what it has to offer, if you want to experience Tawheed, if you want to feel it, to where you feel that this is a pure word, that this is the path of the most praiseworthy, subhanahu wa ta'ala, it has to come from the heart. The heart has to glorify it, appreciate it, value it. And in order to do that, you need to search for it. You need to reflect upon it. You need to look at your own lives and how Tawheed has enhanced it, made it better. And one simple way of doing that is thinking about the dua you have made in your past and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has answered it. When you feel that, because dua is the highest act of worship. It is the embodiment of Tawheed. When you see that, what more beautiful thing can we ask for than to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala above the heavens, above the creation, the King of Kings, the most noble and the most praiseworthy, the most glorified, heard your dua, you individual, heard your dua, accepted it and answered it in a way that brought happiness to your heart. Experience Tawheed. And don't just live it. We all live Tawheed to a level or not. We all live Tawheed, but experiencing it is something far more beautiful, far more profound and deep. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us be among those who are on the path of the pure word and the path of the praiseworthy subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have a few announcements. First of all, subhanAllah, Ramadan is flying by. We are